gonna guess you don't see a lot of chainmail walking around these days, unless you're at a Renaissance fair or a particularly avant-garde fashion show. Or that, like, one specific Chapel Roan performance. Okay, maybe we're seeing a bit more chainmail now than we were a few decades ago. And it turns out even science can't escape the trend. Because one team of researchers recently developed a sort of 3D chainmail, and their invention has some really weird properties that the laws of physics just can't completely explain. These days, we mostly use chainmail in things like kitchen gloves and shark-protecting diving suits, but the oldest examples date back to around 300 BCE. For example, you may have seen depictions of the Roman lorica hamata, which was probably borrowed from early Celtic designs. In Europe, chainmail stayed popular for more than a millennium. Around the 14th century, it started getting replaced by suits of armor, but it stuck around in other parts of the world, like Persia and India, for even longer. And I can kind of see why. It's great at protecting you against slashing damage, so it'd be a critical defense for anyone living in a predominantly sword-based fighting culture. But I can also see why chainmail eventually got replaced. For one thing, it wasn't super great against piercing damage on account of the many, many open spaces, so it was pretty vulnerable to things like stiletto daggers and arrows. Also, because it's basically two-dimensional, a layer of chainmail wasn't amazing against bludgeoning damage. See, the reason it hurts when something hits you, be it a fist or an unrealistically large hammer, is that the collision transfers energy from that something to you. And if an unrealistically large hammer smashes against just one sheet of what is effectively a heavy-duty fabric, the energy is not going to be absorbed or redirected in a way that keeps it away from what's sitting underneath that fabric. By which I mean your fleshy body. Now, to be fair, chainmail is better at preventing blunt force trauma than, say, a cotton denim jacket. The fact that all those interlocked rings can move around relative to one another means they can disperse some of the incoming energy, just not a ton. But what if we thickened all that up? If you pad out your body in foam and have your friend punch you, it's gonna hurt a hell of a lot less than getting punched in your t-shirt. The air pockets in the foam allow it to deform for a bit and dissipate energy before it gets through to the wearer. So foam is pretty protective, but 3D chainmail would be even better. For one thing, it would inherently be made of tougher stuff. For another, it'd be a lot easier to move in. And by virtue of there being a bunch of interlocked links, each link has more axes of movement relative to the others it's attached to. That allows for even more ways to absorb and disperse energy. But to discover all the cool and potentially weird properties that come from turning chainmail 2D into 3D, you have to actually make it, and then do a bunch of experiments with what you made. Which leads me to a team of Caltech researchers who invented something called PAMs. But before I tell you about that, a quick ad. Thanks to Kitsch for supporting this SciShow video. Kitsch makes beauty and wellness products that turn your everyday routine into something special. They believe that everyone should feel confident no matter your hair type, style, or budget. Their products are formulated with rice water and without phthalates, parabens, silicones, or sulfates. And you can get each bar for under $11 with the SciShow discount, or under $21 for both the shampoo and conditioner set. They also have a subscription option for an even better discount. Hiroka, who is behind one of the cameras right now, has been using the shampoo bar, and she says that her normally frizzy hair has been much smoother and also that it feels super voluminous. I have a sensitive scalp, so I personally am very excited to try the hair and scalp oil. Kitsch ships to over 90 countries. Just use the link in the description or the code SciShow to get 25% off your order, which will auto-apply at checkout. Behold, PAMs, aka polycatenated architected materials, which if you speak the right dialect of science jargon, tells you exactly what's going on. Poly means many, caten refers to chains, and architected materials are specific structures made of repeating cells with connecting tissue. So, polycatenated architected materials means lattice-like material built of many chains. That sure sounds like 3D chainmail to me. If you look at any of these PAM blobs, they seem pretty darn simple, but the design process was a bit more complicated than just make chainmail but more. The team started by modeling a solid crystalline lattice. In other words, a solid made of individual particles connected by strong, rigid bonds. Like,
this.
Then they went into that structure and replaced all the particles with what are basically tiny cages linked loosely together instead of being connected by stiff bonds. This added a whole bunch of degrees of movement to the overall material. Finally, they printed out a bunch of spheres and cubes measuring about 5 centimeters across. The PAMs were made of different materials like acrylic and nylon, and the cages took all kinds of shapes, mostly circular, but also some more pyramidal or hexagonal designs. With a bunch of physical samples, the real experimentation could begin. The team tested how each of their PAMs would react to an assortment of forces, focusing on 3 primary ones: compression or squishing force, torsion or twisting force, and shear or sliding force, like the force of water passing over a riverbed. During those tests, the team discovered something pretty cool. When the PAMs were being compressed, they behaved like a solid and stood firm rather than squishing out of the way. But under shear forces, they behaved like a liquid and flowed around obstructions. And the point where the PAMs fully transitioned between solid and liquid depended not just on what forces were acting on them, but also how they were printed. Like, nylon PAMs worked differently than metal PAMs, and round cages worked differently than prism-shaped ones. This sometimes solid, sometimes liquid property can be found elsewhere in nature, and I'm not talking about, like, a cat taking up its bowl that it's sitting in. A big, massive sand can act like both a solid and a liquid because the individual grains can flow over one another. Or think back to your childhood playing with oobleck, that mix of cornstarch and water. If you slap it, it feels solid, but if you slowly stick your finger in it, it's just a thick liquid. All these examples might make you think the scientists behind PAMs understand what's going on, but there's actually entirely new physics needed to explain how they work. Because a lot of the theories we have can only apply sometimes. For example, the kinetic theory of granular materials works when a shear force is applied at like a slow to medium rate, but it doesn't apply when the PAMs are already under a lot of compression. So researchers will have to continue playing with their 3D chainmail in a scientifically rigorous way, but once we eventually understand them a little better, these materials could have a huge number of applications. Remember the whole foam discussion? All the extra degrees of motion that make PAMs even better at energy absorption than foam could make them ideal for protecting fragile objects, like a football player's head. And if scientists learn how to miniaturize the technology, the fact that PAMs can change shape and flow like liquid could make them excellent candidates for protecting our bodies from the inside. Early experiments with microscopic PAMs show that they can respond to electric charge, which may allow us to control their shape remotely. So one day, scientists could design some kind of PAM robot that squishes itself into the right spot in a patient's body, fixes whatever it can, and then squishes out. No invasive procedure required. In the meantime, I'm sure someone out there is already thinking of ways to turn this new kind of chainmail into a fashion statement, or at least a desk toy.